Hi guys, and welcome back in Medical Scribe. In this video, we will talk about the anatomical variations. The anatomical variations are the differences that found in the body structures regarding its size, number, and shape, and also the differences that occur to the structures during aging process and regarding the gender. These differences normally occur between people and mostly will be asymptomatically and don't cause any problems to the person and may want to grow up and die without discovering it. But it can differ in the degree of severity, from asymptomatic, as we said, to incompatible with life. That means the person can't live because of this variation. And these variations mainly caused by the differences in the genetic materials that inherited from the parents, which when expressed will give us these variations between people. And we're supposed to know these variations because it will help us in the physical examination of the patients and in the diagnosis of cases and in the treatment. Alright, the other thing that we should focus on is that how we will discover this variation. In fact, there is many ways to discover it, and in most time, it discovered incidentally. So we can detect it by either the investigational imaging, like the X-ray and the CT scan, or while surgical procedures, or at autopsy. So we can find if the person had a specific variation. And we can consider that the congenital anomalies and the birth defects, which mostly discovered at the birth, is another way to discover the anatomical variations. Okay, may a question come to our mind, which is that how we will study the human anatomy with all these variations that differ from person to person and from a group of people in a specific region to another group in another region? The answer is that the anatomical textbooks all agreed with and say that we will describe the body structures depending on the most common pattern in most people. That means most of the people will share a similar anatomical form. So the textbooks will depend on them in describing. And in the same time, they will tell us if we may find a variation in these structures in some individuals. The last thing that we should know about the anatomical variations is that where we will find these variations mostly. Initially, all we know that the people differ from each other in their physical appearance. It's normally to see differences between two persons regarding their shape, length, and other properties. But we can have variations at the muscles level. These variations include the absence of a specific muscle, or maybe a doubled muscle, or can be changing, increasing, or decreasing in the origin and the insertion of the muscle. For example, we have a muscle called the palmaris longus, which found in the forearm. This muscle may exist in some people, while doesn't exist in others. It's a normal variation. And also, there is a muscle called the sternalis muscle, which lies on the pectoralis major. This muscle will show a wide range of variations between individuals. And we have variations at the bones level. These variations include the difference in the fine features of the bone, like its processes, spines, and the articular surfaces. For example, in the vertebral column, specifically in the lumbar region, normally we have 5 vertebrae. But we may find in some people 6 vertebrae, and in some others, 4 vertebrae. Also, we have variations at the organs level, in which the shape or the size of the organ may be different, depending on the organ normal physiology or on the pathophysiologic changes that have occurred previously to the organ. And finally, we have variations at the neurovascular structures level, which is most occur in the veins. So we can find additional veins or absence of some of them, or we can find anastomosis in some people that don't found in others. And after the veins, we have the arteries in finding variations. And the least one in variations is the nerves. So that was almost everything about the anatomical variations. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.